The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. Second chapter, text number 12, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 12th of February, 1975, in Mexico.
Mati vaham jatunasam natam nemi janadipa nachaiva na bhavishyamaha sarvi vayam ataparam. So Krishna began his teaching to Arjuna, chastising him that you do not know anything, still you are talking like a learned man. This is the fault of a person without any spiritual knowledge. Every man in this material world is almost without any spiritual knowledge. Still, they are proud of their learning, their knowledge, their degrees. This is going on. When Sanatana Goswami approached Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he first of all presented himself as a person without knowledge. Sanatana Goswami was coming of a very Brahmin aristocratic family. He was very learned scholar in Sanskrit and Urdu. Still, he presented himself before Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as a policeman. So actually that is the position. He said, Gramma Bhavahare Kohoe Pundi Sottokori Mane Aponar Hitahit Kichunahi Jani. He said that this common man say that I am very learned, Pandit, but I am such a rascal, I do not know what I am. So this is the position for everyone. You ask any learned scientist, professor, who are you? He'll say, I am Mr. John. He'll say, I am Mr. John, I am American, or I am Mexican, I am Indian, like that. So this is ignorance. Nobody is this body. That is the first lesson of spiritual knowledge. So long we identify with this body, that I am Mr. such and such, I am American, I am Indian, this is all ignorance. When you actually understand that you are not this body, therefore you are not American, nor Indian, nor Mexican, but you are spirit soul, then your spiritual education begins. And that is, in Sanskrit it is called Aham Brahmasmi, I am spirit soul. Spirit soul has no connection with this material world. When one understands fully this fact, that spirit soul is different from this material world, then he is actually learned. In that stage, he is called situated in Brahma-bhuta stage. The symptom of Brahma-bhuta is Brahma-bhuta prasannātmā. As soon as one becomes self-realized, he becomes jubilant, jolly. So now one identifies with this body, he is unhappy, full of anxiety. So Bhagavad Gita begins with this point, that one should know that he is not this material body. That knowledge is lacking at the present moment throughout the whole world. Everyone is identifying with this body, like the animals. Therefore Krishna chastised Arjuna that you have got animalistic concept of life and still is speaking like a very learned scholar. No learned scholar laments on account of this body. It is said in the Bhagavad Gita, dhira sattva namayati dhira. Dhira means one is sober by education, he is not disturbed. Just like when a man dies, his relatives lament, cry, my father is gone, my father is gone, my father is no more, or my son is no more, anyway. They lament like that. But if he is little sober, he can understand, he can study that I am lamenting my father is gone, my son is gone, but he is not gone, he is lying on the bed or on the floor. Then why I am speaking gone? If some friend asks me, why you are lamenting, my father is gone, my son is gone, he is lying here. But he will say, no, he is not, he may be lying there, but he is gone. That is puzzle. He is lying there and gone, what is this contradiction? That is the point to understand about the soul. The relative is lamenting, crying, my father is gone. That means he never saw his father. He saw the body only. But at the time of death of his father, he understands that this father is not this body, that is soul. So when you come to this understanding that every one of us, we may be in different body, but we are not this body, we are spirit soul. So that time our actual knowledge begins. Now Krishna is describing what is the nature of that soul. He says, whenever we sit down together, we say I, you and they. First person, second person and third person. I, you or he. There cannot be more than these three. I can say I can say you, and I can say he. Krishna says in this verse that natu eva aham jatu. Either I, you or he, none of us ever born, because we are not this body. The birth takes place of the body, not of the soul. The soul is described here that he does not take birth. It is not that he was not existing in the past, now he has taken birth. It is not like that, that the soul did not exist in the past, now he is existing. There are some philosophers, they think like that the living symptom was not existing before, and by the combination of matter, the living force is there. But that is not the fact. The living being is there, therefore the life symptoms are there in the body. Therefore, when a man dies, because we do not know about the living force, we cry that my father, my son has gone. So we should acquire knowledge from the authority. Krishna is the authority. He says that all of us, you, me and all the others who have come to join this party, it is not that they did not exist in the past. They existed, we existed all in the past. We are existing now, and after so-called death or after quitting this body, we shall still exist. Now the question will be, how I shall exist, either as American, Indian or something else? So that is very intelligent question. First of all, we have to understand that I, you, every one of us, existed in the past. So how I existed in the past and how I shall exist in future? So past is past, that is gone. Now I am existing as a human being. It is my duty to understand how I shall exist in future. That is intelligence. If we do not prepare for the next life, then we are animals. Just like the human society, there is education. The father gives education to the child, thinking about his future. The cats and dogs, they do not give any education, neither they know what is the meaning of education. That is the difference between human being and animal. So, if you are not educated in the matter of understanding what is our future, then we are no better than the animal. That education we can have in this human form of life that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Janti devabrata devan pitrin janti pitribhataha bhute cha janti bhutani madhyajinopi janti mam. The process is there. You can prepare your next life in this life. Just like they are attempting to go to the moon planet. But the fact is, they could not go there. Why they could not go there? The reason is that wherever you go, you must be fit for that place. Even in this planet, suppose somebody goes from one place to another place, he has to make himself fit to go there. He must know what is the temperature there. Accordingly, he will take his dress, then he will have to take permission of the state, visa, passport, so many things. You have to arrange, then you can go. Not that all of a sudden anyone can come to your country, Mexico, without arrangement. Similarly, if you want to go to the higher planetary system, then you have to make your arrangement in this life. You cannot go to the moon planet by force because you have got a teeny airplane. That is not possible. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita says, Janti deva bhuta devan. A man can go to the higher planetary system when he is preparing himself to go there. So there are millions and trillions of planets. Wherever you want, you can go. The descriptions are there in the Shastra. But there is another description, the kingdom of God. That kingdom of God is there beyond this material sky. So we have to take information where that spiritual world is there. You can have it from Vedic literature. In the Bhagavad Gita it is said, parastasmat tu bhava anya bhaktya bhaktya sanatana. There is another nature, the spiritual nature, which is beyond this material nature. That material nature, bhakta bhakta, means some portion is manifested and some portion is not manifested. And we get information from Bhagavad Gita that the spiritual nature is beyond this manifested and non-manifested cosmic situation. So Krishna says, the Supreme Authority says, madhyajinopi janti mam. If somebody cultivates Krishna consciousness, he can go there. It is not difficult. Simply you have to change your mode of life. To become Krishna conscious means to be pure in the original spiritual existence. We are pure as Brahma, as spirit soul, but because we have contaminated this material modes of nature, our consciousness is now different. So, on account of different consciousness, there are three classes of men. One class of man is very intelligent, one class of man very passionate, and one class of man fools and duskers. So, in order to understand your promotion to the spiritual world, you have to become first class man. First class man means Brahmana. Brahmana means he is truthful, he is self-controlled, he is simple, he is tolerant. In this way, there are nine qualifications to become first class man. And to become first-class man, the preliminary qualification is that you should not become sinful. So, instead of becoming sinful, to become pious, you simply follow these four regulative principles. The first principle is illicit sex. That is forbidden. It is, sex is not forbidden, but illicit sex is forbidden. That is not very difficult. Everyone wants, that is the necessity of the body, that sex, as we want to eat, as we want to sleep, similarly there is sex desire. But if you want to become first-class man, then don't have illicit sex. Except marriage, do not have sex. The human society, therefore human society, there is marriage. There is no marriage in the dog society. So therefore, sex life within marriage and regulative principle, that is not prohibited. That means anyone who follows these rules and regulations, he becomes purified and pious. Without becoming purified and pious, you cannot understand God. It is said therefore in the Bhagavad Gita, Jesham tu antagatam papam jananam punyakarmanam te dandamaha nirmukta bhajanti maang virabhrita. Person who is completely free from sinful activities, such person can become a devotee, a lover of God. So this Krishna consciousness movement is teaching to the human society how to become purified. There is no such restriction that this man can be purified, that man cannot be. No, there is nothing like that. Everyone can be purified if he desires to be so. So, immediately we may not be able to purify as it is prescribed, no illicit sex, no meat eating, no gambling, no intoxication. It may not be possible because those who are accustomed, it is difficult to give up. Therefore, the process is given very simple, chant Hare Krishna. So, purification is absolute, that is necessary. Without purification, you cannot understand God. But the method we are prescribing, not we are prescribing, it is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's prescription, we are simply propagating, that chant Hare Krishna. So I am very glad to see that you Mexican young boys, girls, ladies and gentlemen are coming here and joining the chanting Hare Krishna mantra. So I request you to continue this procedure. Please come here, join this chanting of Hare Krishna mantra and take prasadam and go home. And surely you will be purified and qualified for going back to home, back to God. Thank you very much. That we have already said. No illicit sex, no gambling, no meat eating, no intoxication.
It is possible that the parents receive protection.
Yes. Human being is meant for marriage, not the cats and dogs. If you can remain without marriage, without sex life, that is very good. But if you cannot, then marry and be gentleman and remain peaceful.
If you want to achieve Krishna consciousness outside of the
room. Oh yes. You have to follow the rules and regulations, that's all.
The
same activities, simply there is no simple activity.
But what basic principle can Krishna forgive
us? Yes, Krishna can forgive you once, twice, not one, regularly.
That by talking about the gratitude, he has to be eliminated, but is there any way to more rapidly
If a man comes, follows the regulative principle, even for some time, and again he falls down, so long he has followed, that asset is permanent. Anything spiritual asset that is never lost. So little, when it is complete 100%, then you become liberated. Spiritual asset is never lost. So even a person comes to the temple and follows the regulative principle for some time, again he falls down. He is not loser, he is gainer. Others who do not take this lesson and outside, they may perform his so-called duties very perfectly, he is loser. So, at least for some time, let every one of you come here and follow the restriction. And if you become perfect, it's all right. But even if you go away, whatever you have done, that is your permanent asset. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Salpamapi yasya dharma satrayati mahato bhava. And even that little asset can help you to become free from the greatest danger. There are many examples that are stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Therefore, in this human form of life, at least we shall try to get some spiritual asset. So in the Bhagavad Gita it is stated, even such person falls down, he is given chance next life to take birth in very rich aristocratic family or in a very pious Brahman family. So, little spiritual asset in this human form of life will at least guarantee your next life in a very nice family. But without spiritual life, there is no guarantee whether you are going to become human being or cat or dog.